No one will tell you these money secrets. Have you ever wondered why Elon Musk, Warren Buffett, Bill Gates, Richard Branson, and Jeff Bezos credits their success to reading books? After reading and researching through these 50+ personal finance books over the period of last 5 years and applying their lessons in my life, my financial life changed completely. Over the journey, I discovered a pattern emerge which is common across all these books, which I call it 10 eye-opening money secrets that no one tells you. These secrets are as powerful as an elixir, as lively as the wine, and as potent as a venom, and they can transform your life instantly. From saving on assets to spending on value, and on understanding inflation to the power of compounding and automation, these 10 secrets will give you fresh insights to rethink about your approach and understanding about money. And don't forget to check the description of the whole 50 books listed under each sections in the description. Let's get straight to the secret number one. Secret number one, spending on luxury will make you rich. Yes, I said it right. Money is an energy. The way you interact with that energy matters. So when you spend on money, you will have that appreciation and gratitude towards money that will make the universe to attract more riches back to you. Even when you are in debt, try to spend at least 10% of your income on such luxurious, wealthy item that will motivate you to earn more, and that way you will attract more of abundance back to you. A tip is to use cash instead of card. A card is just a plastic, but your cash has life in it, so use that life. Secret number two, having debt is a gifted curse to become you richer. Yes, debt is a curse. It will actually challenge the core of your existence. But if you are determined to get rid of debt, then that discipline will pay off, and once you finish paying off the debt, that same discipline can be used to create wealth for you. Secret number three, you should make money while you are sleeping. Yes, Warren Buffett told, if you are not doing that, you will work until you die and you will not be richer also. Suppose even you have a very gigantic salary and you are earning enormous profits from your company. Still, your health, everything can be risk. Your job is at risk, your company could be in risk, and even your business could collapse. So try to make sure that you earn money while you are sleeping, while you watch TV, or while you are just enjoying your shower as well. Secret number four, money degrades when it sleeps in your bank account. You can safely put your money in the bank account, that's true. But if you are planning to become rich or abundant or wealthy by putting the money into the bank, actually your today's money is more valuable than tomorrow's money. Or put it another way, your value of your money will degrade. You can buy less number of items in future when you put that money in your bank account. Instead, if you take that same amount of money and put it somewhere, it will generate more wealth. Secret number five, be friend with your money. The revenge will pay back. So having a healthy relationship with money is essential. If you feel that having money is actually greed or unwise, then the moment you get some money or income or anything, you will find a way to get rid of it. This could be coming from societal conditioning, or from the movie, or from culture, or your understanding subconsciously. So you have to make sure that your money, your currency, or the bill, actually that's your friend, your partner, your ally in living a wonderful life for you. Even when you are spending something. Secret number six, be frugal but not cheap. Invest in value. So there's a famous saying telling that if you buy cheap, you buy twice. So frugality is not cheap. Frugality is somewhere you are having a due diligence or re-evaluating the value of a particular item before you invest on it. That's important. It is happening on every part of your life. Even if you're buying, say, an item, a keyboard or a pen or anything. So that way you can save your money and make sure that all the items or the things you buy, it will stay with you as well. Secret number seven, risks can reward you and punish you as well. So the gigantic profit you are getting from your business is because you take a risk to start that business instead of someone else waiting there, hesitating to start because of the fear of failure. Same thing applies that you are paying a very high amount of interest rate to your credit card because you take a big risk, or bank took a big risk on giving you money without making sure that you have a position to pay back. So in both cases, risk is punishing you and rewarding you. That's the thing. So you should make sure, you should not ignore the risk. That's not the case. You should evaluate it, understand it, mitigate it, analyze it, and somehow you can accept it also. So one way to consider it is diversification, or in put it simply, put your eggs in multiple baskets so that the damage on one basket will not impact you. That's the point. So we have another book summary in our channel called Algebra of Wealth, which we are explaining in detail about such topics. But in short, diversification is important, and you should respect and analyze and somehow enjoy taking the risk as well. So one short example of diversification is that if you're planning to invest, trying to invest in opposite polar items like stock and gold. Usually if you look at in the market, when the stock go down, gold will go up. Secret number 8, automate and see the 8th wonder. Yes, Albert Einstein, I'm not sure he told it or not, but compound interest is the 8th wonder. That's what people told us. So the point is that automation is somehow for sure it is going to save your time in paying your bills and making your investment. But it's not ending there. There is a psychological dimension to it also. So instead, if you are automating your thing, it is not allowing you to think like, okay, I will save something what is left over. Instead, the system automatically will pull your money to your expenses and your investment, and you have less available bandwidth to allow your cognitive biases to control your money. And once in a while, when you look back, you will see that the money is too much there. Maybe it's not your money, because that's the 8th wonder, compounding. In Millionaire Next Door, the book, they told that there is one thing common among all the millennials. That is, they all do budgeting. Budgeting may think like an extra effort, or a waste of time, or a simple exercise. Maybe it's all like that. You'll think that you have everything already in your brain. Why should I budget? But actually, budgeting is a very powerful tool. It is a fundamental tool to your personal finance and management. One way, it will give you a small picture and a big picture. One way to look at it is to just make multiple baskets or buckets for it, we call it. So say, you should always live below your means. That's a secret. At least only spend 55% of your income or less than that on your expenses. And the remaining 45%, you will divide across 4 ways. One is long-term and short-term investment. 20% will go there. And another 10% you'll spend for your education and improvement. And another 10% for the secret number 1. Yes, I mean it. For luxurious spending. And 5% remaining, you should give back to the community. Secret number 10. Think big and feel big. Just dreams don't work. Manifestations and affirmations also mostly don't work. There is a critical part in manifesting, that is the belief or the thought that, or the faith that this will happen back to you. That is a principle explained in Think and Grow Rich and even any other manifestations book further to it, including Law of Attraction. Many of us have a limited mindset, or we think that, okay, Ferrari is not for us, Rolls Royce is not at all for us. Maybe you think like that. But actually, if you really like a Rolls Royce, you should think that you are riding one. That's important. Then only your mind, or in another way to put it, universe only fill a cup which is free. It will not fill a cup which is overflowing or which does not have a space. So these 10 eye-opening secrets has been distilled from 50 financial books, as we mentioned in our introduction. All of them is already listed in the description as well. So just knowing this is not sufficient. You should try to make sure that you are applying it immediately. Just automate your spendings, diversify your investment, and let us have a budget that will make your financial abundant. And always make sure these 10 secrets are always with you in your financial journey, and your success is inevitable and invincible as well. So until we come across with the next book, thank you for watching. Thank you for all your support. Bye for now.